You're watching Ask BQ on Bloomberg Quint, and with me is Pradeep Pandya, everyone. Hi, I'm Navneet Saluja D'Souza. Let me straight away go to our guest and introduce them, who will be helping our viewers to address their queries today. Hemen Kapadia is joining us to help us with the fundamentals, and also joining us is Rakesh Bansal, who's the Vice President of RK Global. Good afternoon to you, gentlemen, and thanks very much for joining us today on Bloomberg Quint.
Well, if you look at markets right now, they are trying to hold on, and we have crossed 99.50. I think that's good news, really, for traders, because 99.50 was seen as a hurdle. We are trying to hold above that level. Small cap is doing much better, so there is a broad-based buying interest seen. So we'll keep watching the index levels. But let's go across to our callers and find out what are the questions that have come in today for our two experts, Rakesh and Hemen. I think the first query that I can see is from Abhinandan, who has written to us. He has 2,000 shares of Suzlon Energy at 24.45. Oh, he's really staring at a huge loss. So he has a long-term view, though. Hemen, do you advise Suzlon should be a hold even at this level, you know, after losing 9 rupees at least? That is more or less 50%.
Well, Pradeep, yes and no. No, because it was showing a lot of promise, which seems to have fizzled out. Yes, simply because, like you mentioned, he's losing so much of money. I'm not sure what else should I recommend him in the same price range. It could take some time. I think 12.5-13 is a make or break level. I think that needs to hold. And till we don't take out 21 on the weekly chart, Pradeep, I don't think this is going anywhere. So inadvertently, it is a long-term investment, so I'd suggest a hold at this level.
All right, that's the view coming in on Suzlon. Let's move to our next query, which comes from Raj Shah. He's written to us. He's got 500 shares of Bhansali Engineering, which he bought at a price of 83. He wants to know, what should he do? Should he hold or sell? Well, this is the company which has been on a tear. In fact, we've seen a huge surge coming about. If you look at YTD, currently the stock's trading at levels of about 106. So he's bought somewhere at the higher band of the stock price. I mean, Bhansali Engineering on the charts, 106, very much in the money. But this year, the stock's already risen almost 375%. Do you think it would be appropriate to book profits?
Partially, yes. Navneet, I think that makes a lot of sense to take some profit home. Stock is in a short, medium, long-term uptrend. Is that an all-time high? No known resistance levels to look at. But like you said, looking at the quantum of the rise, it's a hold with a partial profit booking, because, yeah, I think it makes sense to book some profit.
Okay, so that is a call on Bhansali Engineering. Let's move forward to our next caller, and this one is on DV's Lab. Monty Sharma writes to us on Twitter. He has 500 shares of DV's Lab, bought at 880 rupees with a short-term view, and he wants to know if he should hold or sell. So short-term view is needed here on DV's Lab. Rakesh, what do you advise?
Since the view is short-term, view is trading, so one should firstly place a stop loss at 830 levels, then keep a close eye on 890 levels. 890 level is a major make or break level. Once 890 levels are cracked on an upside, then we are likely to see a level of 935. The chances of 890 levels being cracked on upside are high. One should hold, place a stop loss at 830, and once 890 levels are cracked, then sit patiently. Then I think momentum will come into an action, and then hold for a target price of 935.
All right, that's the view coming in on Divi's Laboratories. The stock in the last 3 months has seen some sort of rebound. It's up almost 31%. Let's take our another viewer query, which comes from Suhas Vyas, who writes to us on Facebook. Suhas has got 100 shares of ITC, which he bought at a price of 385, and I believe that's almost at the 52-week high levels where he's bought. He has a one-year view and wants to know, what should he do? ITC currently at 265. Hemen, what do you think Suhas should do?
I would not normally tell him to average a bad trade, but I guess he doesn't have a choice. 385 is not coming in the near future. But I have a feeling this 385 is cum bonus, because ex bonus, it's not showing 385, so I'm sure it must be cum bonus. But I think it's a hold. We've come off from 352 to 258. I know he has a slightly longer term view. It's bottomed out in the short term. Now this looks set to convert into the medium term. And taking a very longer term view on ITC, the stock has been in an uptrend for the last 31 years or so, and that still hasn't changed. So I'd suggest to hold, but to expect him to break even in the near future, not possible.
Okay, so that's your call on ITC. Let's take the next query, which is on Orient Pro Solution. This is from Chintan. He writes to us on Twitter. He has 1,400 shares of Orient Pro, bought at 150 rupees. He has a 6 months view on this. Well, this is not a very very actively tracked counter, Rakesh, but do you have Orient Pro on your radar? You'll have a call?
Yeah, I've got a call. If you see, the positive part is that stock prices has made a good base at around 130 levels, and in near future, I don't think stock prices are likely to go down below 130 levels. One should hold and hold for a target price of 175. And since, as you have mentioned, like it's most people have not heard, so one should not be greedy and one should clearly book profit at around 175 levels on the upside.
All right, that's the view coming in on Orient Pro. Well, the stock currently has been trading around, not much of actually movement seen there, but we're getting a lot of live queries coming in on Facebook as well as Twitter. Let's take a look at the live Twitter queries first. Let me first take the query of Sandeep Menon. Well, he's written to us. He says, should I hold Snowman Logistics? He's holding 300 shares of that, which he bought at a price of almost 66 rupees. He remain on the charts. Do you think he should be holding on to this?
Ever since it got listed, Navneet, Snowman is making lower top, lower bottoms. Simply put, we are in a downtrend. And we are, I think, close to a rather important level, Navneet, which comes in at around 50. We've turned from this level a couple of times in the last couple of years. So I'd keep that as a stop loss. If that cracks, there's going to be hell to pay. Otherwise, it's getting oversold. Downside does appear limited, but being oversold does not mean it's out of the woods. It would need a weekly close above 56, Navneet. A weekly close, not a daily close. A weekly close above 56 for the medium-term trend to reverse. So I think as of now, it's a hold with a stop loss at 50.
So right now, you can hold on to this stock, Sandeep. That's the call. Sachin Pangarkar, if I'm reading it correctly. Sachin has got 100 shares of Moil. He bought at 357. He wants a technical view as well as fundamental. Well, we could get you a technical view for sure. 357 is your buying price on Moil. Rakesh, what do you think?
It's a very high price, but as of now, the worst seems to be over for a stock, and very clearly, I'm not able to see a price of 350 on the charts. There might be some bonus or something like this, and the technical structure is good, and the kind of technical structure stock price is having is very positive, and they are making a base to crack a major neckline at 200 levels, and once the 200 is taken off, then we are likely to see a big rally towards 245, 250. Stock is a clear hold. Any decline to around 165, 170 levels would be an excellent buying opportunity. At those levels, one can add more.
Okay. So this was a cum bonus price at 357. If so, then the Sachin is actually in that case sitting on a profit. May not be very high profit, but definitely some positive gains.
Right, that's the view coming in on Moil. But let's take another query, which comes from Pratik. He's written to us on Twitter. He wants a view on NHPC. He wants to know, should he invest in this or not? I mean, on the charts, do you think the current levels are good enough for Pratik to take any position in NHPC?
The monthly mechanical indicators are in sell mode, Navneet. It's in an intermediate downtrend. And unless he's comparing the returns to a fixed deposit, NHPC has gone nowhere since listing in the last 7 years. It moves at a snail's pace. So even if I were to go for something in the government arena, I think NTPC should probably provide better return than NHPC, because it just doesn't do anything much.
All All right, that's the view coming in on NHPC. Let me just take some live queries which are coming on Facebook right now. Jay Sudasama has written to us. He's asking if there's any view on Pennar Industries. He's been holding this counter from 47 levels. Let's just pull up the chart of Pennar Industries. That's the query which Jay has come up with. Pennar currently is trading at levels of almost 60 rupees and he's been holding from 47 levels. Rakesh, what would you suggest, Jay? He's pretty much in the money. Should he hold on? Can one expect higher levels on Pennar?
Well, Navneet, one should clearly hold on. The technical structure is very good. The stock is on a big re-rating. And if any viewers wants to add at current market price of 60, one can add more. If you are adding from a trading point of view, then keep a stop loss at 57. Else from an investment point of view, stock is an excellent re-rating candidate and stock is making a base to crack a major neckline at 67 levels. And once the 67 neckline is cracked on the upside, then we are likely to see a level of 88, 90 on the upside. In next 6 to 8 months, stock is a strong buying candidate at current levels.
All right, that's the view coming in on Pennar Industries, which currently trades at that level of 60 rupees. Well, we're running out of time. We'll thank our guest on that note, Hemen, as well as Rakesh. Appreciate both of you joining and also waiting for the show to start. With that, we'll wrap it up here on this edition of Ask BQ. But remember, we're just a tweet, post or a call away. So keep your queries coming and we promise to address all of them through our shows. Don't go anywhere. Power Lunch is up next, so keep it up with Bloomberg Quint Live.